ASMR. So for this video, I had actually gotten a request from Caleb's ASMR. So not to get confused with Caleb ASMR, but he was asking, just do a video about me. So I will do my best. A video, short enough, because I could probably, of course, everybody, everybody has a lot to say about themselves, so, I could probably spend hours and hours and hours, just talking about myself, but, I'll try and keep it relatively short. So, I guess I'll just kind of history, the history of just like my early childhood, and then kind of what I've been dealing with for the past several years, because I'm still kind of on quite a journey, I guess you could say. But anyways, so I was technically I was born in Massachusetts. So always been in, or for the most part, always been in New England, that northeast area. The majority of my childhood, I actually grew up in New Hampshire. So I moved around a lot when I was a kid. I don't really know why exactly. I think my dad just kind of, jumped around, did different things. So I moved around a lot when I was a kid, and so because of that, yes, because of that, and also I think just because of genes and, how I was raised and all that stuff, turned out that it was very difficult for me to, socialize with people, so it took a lot longer for me to, gain those social skills. Set me back a little bit, but it's okay. But yeah, so moved around a lot when I was a kid. I kind of I started working really early. I think my dad kind of gave me a pretty good work ethic. Very young as a kid, doing a lot of yard work and stuff. I had actually even before my first job that I had, I would go around and shovel snow and rake leaves and stuff, for, just around the neighborhood for money. And then I think I got my first job at 14, 13 or 14 or something. It was a paper route. So I was a newspaper deliverer. So that was a pretty cool job. It didn't pay that much, but that was, I thought it was very cool. The only day I had off was Christmas, and so I had to work every single day, even if it was through a storm and stuff. But I'd just jump on my scooter and just kind of zip around, I think, because eventually I picked up another paper route, so I was doing two. And I think I had to deliver around exactly how many, maybe 100, around 100 different people. But so that was pretty fun. But I jumped around for a few different jobs. When I was in high school, I did a lot of landscaping work, and in addition to that, I also worked at a KFC, or a KFC Taco Bell mix, but I was the chicken cook in the back, so that was, it was okay. Some good experience in food service, I suppose. But, so, yeah, when I was in high school, I had plans on, I guess it was probably middle school, wasn't any like real reason to it. It was just kind of, you know, I think it was for like a class or a project. We had to, you know, think of something that we might do when we grow up. I was like, oh, well, I mean, the Army sounds kind of cool. You know, I like it, the outdoors, and I like adventure and stuff. So, you know, it probably makes sense. And so I think that's kind of when I started to have my first interest in the Army. And so in high school, the last 2 years of high school, because I moved again like halfway in high school. So for the second half, I stumbled across a junior ROTC program for the Air Force. And for those who don't know what that is, it's pretty much like, it's like a high school program for people that, well, I guess there's a few different reasons you could join it, but essentially, like, you'll wear a military style uniform, and, you know, learn about the military. For me, since it was an Air Force one, I learned a lot about the Air Force. I learned a lot about like drill and ceremony and like marching and stuff. So it's another way to, I guess, kind of get a feel for what the military is like. And at least for me, that's actually where I found my first mentor, who really taught me a lot about like, I guess, being like professional and being a leader and stuff like that. So I thought that was pretty cool. But so after that, I ended up going to, well, okay, so while I was in junior RTC, that's when I decided not only did I want to join the Army, but I also wanted to become an officer in the Army, because for me, you know, I was always like a go-getter and stuff. I did like a lot of sports throughout my life, not necessarily because I wanted to. I think my dad kind of pushed me into it when I was a lot younger, so I just kind of kept on doing it. But so I was very competitive and always wanted to be like the best. So I decided, okay, well, I guess that means I should become an officer. So I ended up going to college. I went to a military college, and that was absolutely incredible. Loved it so much. You know, there was just, like, I learned a lot. I got trained a lot. You know, I was able to push myself, like, beyond what I thought I'd be able to. And, you know, I learned a ton about, like, leadership and management. I ended up majoring in business, so I learned a lot more about, you know, business and management and stuff and that, too. So it was a phenomenal experience. And the only problem was, because at the time when I first came in, I had actually like just about gotten a full ride scholarship from the Army, and so then I'd be guaranteed to become an officer after I graduated, which sounds like amazing, right? It's exactly what I wanted. And so, you know, for the first, I'd say 2 or 3 years, I was, you know, I was rock solid, doing great. And then I made my, I would say, as of now, as of today, probably my biggest mistake that I've made in my life so far. And that was, I believe it was the very beginning of my junior year. So okay, so I should start with when I was a freshman, I had aspirations on becoming a pilot. I think I was kind of influenced a little bit during the junior RTC, since it was like Air Force based. So I learned a lot about aviation, and I was actually able to go fly in a Cessna like for a little bit. So I think it kind of got me interested in aviation. So, and also, I found out my freshman year that the, I don't know whether it's true or not, but supposedly the two badges to get as an officer is infantry and aviation. So, of course, me being the competitive person that I am, I was like, all right, well, I want to get one of these two. So I was looking at both of them. I was like, I don't really want to, you know, walk around everywhere. I'd rather fly. So I was like, all right, I'll pursue aviation. And so part of that process was I had to take a test. And, you know, just like an Army aviation or like a pilot test. And what ended up happening was, you know, obviously I have to take full responsibility of it. But I ended up, you know, I trusted someone that I probably shouldn't have trusted. And I ended up cheating on the test. So there's a rule in it where you're not supposed to use your cell phone or any like external sources like to help you. And so I ended up using my phone on, you know, some of the problems. And so I thought it was gonna be fine because there was only a few people that knew about it, but eventually the word got out and I got reported and I ended up losing my commission, so I couldn't become an officer afterwards. And I lost like, I think probably like half the money that I was supposed to get from the scholarship. So I actually still had to pay quite a bit of money. And the school's not very cheap either. I think 4 years of there is like almost $200,000. So that's like a lot of money. But so yeah, I ended up having to like pay a lot of money back. But there was kind of like a choice that they gave me. I could either just walk away and go into the civilian world and kind of do whatever I wanted, but I would have to pay back the Army like $90,000. Or I could enlist for at least 3 years and I wouldn't have to pay back the $90,000. So in my head at the time, I was like, I mean, it's kind of a no-brainer. You know, I would obviously rather save $90,000, and I had also planned, since I still wanted to become a pilot, I had planned I could always enlist and then become a warrant officer, you know, right when I enlist. And the big difference between like an officer pilot and a warrant officer pilot is typically the warrant officers tend to fly more, usually after the officer gets into like a staff position, then they really only fly enough to like hit their requirements. So I was like, all right, well, I probably would have ended up becoming a warrant officer anyways. So I thought, no, this is perfect. You know, still gonna go how I'm planning how I'm going. So then I enlisted. I ended up enlisting in aviation, so I became a mechanic, which I think is hilarious because I had like kind of an understanding of mechanics, but like I honestly didn't know the difference between like a nut and a bolt before I went out for training. So I just think it's a little funny. But I ended up having a contract for 6 years, so a little longer than usual, only because it's aviation and the training's like a little bit longer. So, but at the time I didn't think it was gonna matter because I was still planning on making the Army a career and being able to fly. So I didn't think too much of it. And so I enlisted, and I learned a ton. Well, let me say that. let me say that over. Basic training, I honestly, I learned nothing. A lot of the knowledge that I would have learned from basic, I had already learned in college. And then for the advanced training for like my actual job, that's where I learned a lot. You know, everything about like mechanics and you know, like aviation, like how helicopters work and stuff. So I thought that was really incredible. And then my first duty station, I ended up going to the last place I wanted to go. So, you know, I guess it's okay. But so I got there and I immediately started working on my warrant officer packet, because I figured, you know, I want to become an officer as quickly as possible. I want to start flying as soon as possible. So I, you know, I got my packet all together, and I think it was maybe six or seven months later, I had my entire packet like completely done. It was like perfect packet, and I got my my flight physical results back, and turns out I was medically disqualified because of my eyes. Now, here's the deal with my eyes. Yes, my eyes were incredibly bad. It seemed, yeah, I think the majority of my family has really bad eyesight and wears glasses. But I actually got, I had the PRK eye surgery. I think it was back in like 2013. And so like now my eyes are perfect, you know, 20/20. Actually, I think they're a little bit better than 20/20. So like, realistically, you know, it shouldn't be a problem. But I found out, supposedly the Army has a specific regulation where they base some of it off like the pre-op standards. So because my eyesight was like super bad before the surgery, they still like they wouldn't even give me a waiver or like an exception to policy or anything. So they just said, nope, you're disqualified, you can't fly. And what I soon found out, very shortly after that, because I figured if I wasn't able to become a pilot, I could at the very least be part of the crew, like on the helicopter, since I work on the Chinook helicopter, so like the really, really big ones with the big propellers, like both on top. And so it's a really big helicopter, and so I figured I could, you know, I could crew on one of those, just be you know, work my way up to like a flight engineer or something. And I found out that it was the exact same process, or at least the initial process, for like becoming a pilot as it is to fly like as part of the crew. So I found I was unable to become part of the crew as well. So it was at this time that I think I changed quite a, like it was a pretty big turning point in my life, I think, because you know, throughout my life up until that point, I mean, like, you know, I had a lot of different struggles. I had, you know, a lot of things to deal with, you know, especially like with, you know, social anxiety and stuff like that, having to like push I still had like many, many more years left in the contract, and I was doing something that I did not want to do, and the thing that I wanted to do, I couldn't do. So it was very hard, I guess, to say the least. So yeah, I mean, that's kind of when I started trying to do a lot of different things. I know I had originally planned on, after I was done with the Army, I was going to go into business and do some things in business. And so I decided I could try and start doing that early. And so I started poking around at different things for business. You know, like a lot of it didn't really work out. And, you know, I always ended up becoming very frustrated and depressed, because like the majority of my time was being used up by the Army. And so I didn't really have much time to work on what I wanted to work on. So yeah, it ended up coming to a point where I completely broke down. I think I just completely snapped. And I end up seeing there's like a civilian psychologist. I am seeing like behavioral health and stuff, and I saw him for like, you know, months and months and months. And I just like I don't know, I couldn't figure it out. I just felt so trapped and so like cheated, I guess. And it was very hard. And I mean, it still is very hard. You know, I'm still in the Army right now. And it was very difficult. And it wasn't until you know, a little bit later. I think this was. Actually, I think it was about a year ago. About a year ago, I ended up bringing it up to, you know, like my supervisor, and you know, I was trying to figure out a way to get like an early discharge, so that, you know, I could start working on like business and what I wanted to work on. And it turned out that they found a way to give me an early discharge. And you know, of course, I was ecstatic. And they said, you know, you'll be out by, I think they said like May or June or something like that. And you know, they told me, you know, this and this is gonna happen, and you know, it'll be great. So, you know, I'm sitting there, and, you know, I pass by all these benchmarks, and I'm like, okay, great, you know, this is looking good. I start preparing for, like, what I'm going to do after I leave. And then, you know, May passes by, June passes by, July passes by. I'm like, what the heck is going on? And so I end up bringing it up again. And by this time, a lot of my, you know, like my chain of commander supervisors had actually like changed, so I had new ones. And I apparently like something got lost in translation, or something happened, so I was basically exactly where I was beforehand. And so then I also, you know, I think at that point is kind of when I had another big like mental shift, I suppose you could say. And you know, I think like that specific day when I found out like nothing's happening, I was extremely depressed for that day, maybe even the next day too. But you know, that's kind of when I realized that, free than I realized. I guess less trapped than I realized. And, you know, I really just had to stop, like, you know, blaming the army for, you know, what I couldn't do, I guess. So, you know, when that happened, I actually found out that I was a lot more proactive about, you know, business and stuff, and that's actually when I started doing this YouTube channel. So as you can see, it's still cooking, so I guess that's good. But see, so yeah, I was, you know, I think it definitely helped. It ended up helping me to kind of, you know, work harder, work a little bit more, worry a lot less about the army. And, you know, obviously it, you know, especially like right now, you know, the past week or so, you know, it's, you know, it can still get pretty hard. And, you know, sometimes I'll, you know, feel pretty down or depressed, but, you know, as long as I, you know, take care of myself pretty well, then it doesn't last for too long. So, I found out last weekend that I really need to take care of myself, because, you know, I'd been, actually been, like, overworking myself quite a bit beforehand, and then, like, I completely crashed. So, I think I'm on kind of the tail end of that crash, so I'm starting to kind of pick it back up again, which is good, but I'll have to remember, like, take care of myself and make sure I take those breaks and stuff. So, yeah, I mean, I guess that's generally, like, I guess my primary life story, as far as the, you know, I guess kind of the things that I enjoy and kind of the extras, you know, hobbies or whatever. You know, I actually don't do much right now, mainly because, you know, I don't have, like, the money and stuff, but I really love rock climbing. I started playing the piano about, I think, a year ago, so that's been pretty fun. I also, I say I'm in the process of getting my civilian pilot's license. I started, like, when was it? Like, I think it was like 2 years ago was when I started, and then I was so close to being done, and then that's when I started getting, like, super depressed, so I never ended up finishing it, and then I also ran out of money and stuff, too, because it's pretty expensive. So I've actually, I'm hoping by the end of the year I should be able to finish that, too. So, anyways, I love flying, so I've actually been able to fly, like, Cessnas and Pipers and stuff, which is pretty fun. I love traveling, I love hiking, adventure, and stuff like that. I do enjoy, like, video games and stuff. I used to play a ton when I was a kid. Nowadays, not as much. I know I'm still working on the Fire Emblem Three Houses game. Then I was poking around to, like, Mario Maker and Sekiro and stuff like that, but I think more often than not, if I'm relaxing, I'll usually watch anime. So, yeah, I tend to, I think I got into anime, like, I don't know, it was maybe like 6 or 7 years ago. My older brother, like, hooked me into it. I ended up, the first one I watched was Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood, and so that was a really good one. I just finished, I usually have like a dozen in queue, like, that I try and work on. I think I just finished Demon Slayer, so that was a phenomenal think it was the very beginning of this year, was when I was first introduced to ASMR, and that tended to help me a lot with, like, you know, like anxiety and depression and stuff like that. So it's just, you know, a good way to relax and relieve stress. So yeah, that's kind of when I first started getting into it, and so I figured I could I guess pay it forward, you know, make an ASMR channel, help other people. I know there's like several different reasons why people you know, watch or listen to ASMR, so I know lots of different ways that I can help people, so that's what I'm here for. But I would like it to be able to grow and be able to reach a lot more people, help a lot more people. There's like a few different ideas I have for the channel once it gets big enough. I can't really do it now, just because it's still in like the starting stages. But I do have some pretty big plans for this channel. And then I'm also trying to do like a kind of like a part-time thing as a closer. So I'll be getting into a lot of like high ticket sales and stuff. That'll give me a good start in, you know, kind of understanding the business world, like, you know, I guess a closer view than college, you know, taught me. So I'll be doing that. And then I think there's like one or two app ideas that I have that I'd like to start. And then eventually I would like to get into aviation, right? Doing business in aviation, which I already know is going to be very difficult. I've heard aviation is a pretty cutthroat place to do business in. I've heard if you want to make millions of dollars in aviation, that you have to start off with billions of dollars because you just lose money. So, regardless of that, I would like to get into it, and I do have a few different ideas that I think would be pretty cool. So, as to when I'll actually be able to start working on that, I'm not entirely sure. I mean, I would like to hope in maybe 5 to 10 years, I'd like to be able to, I guess, learn a little bit more about business first, kind of gain that confidence, and then I can really get started on it. But, so, I guess that's more or less about me. You know, I tried keeping it pretty short. It's still pretty, I guess, a longer than normal video. That's kind of the down and dirty of, you know, who I am and I guess where I'm going. But if you guys have any questions, you know, feel free to ask me. You know, I'm always happy to answer any questions and, you know, talk with you guys. So, yes, so that is it. If you would like to support me, you can comment, like, and subscribe. Or if you want to take a step further.